what was unique about Robert, he would sing a song, but it was all syllables. It wasn't any words.
He's the only person I know of who did this little Walter harmonica thing, but he didn't play the harmonica. He would go,
seeing Robert play his nose was memorable. And Robert had this way of playing his nose like it was a harmonica. So that was an interesting twist.
People would think he's playing a harmonica. He was just, I don't know how he did it, but it was, very rarely did he sing lyrics.
He was very good with phonetics. And, that's basically, that's what music's about. It's not really what the lyrics say or the words. Great if that has resonance, but he was all about, this is just part, the vocal is another instrument.
And his voice was like an instrument. It really wasn't like a vocal. It was hard to describe.
The thing is, Robert's an underrated blues star. I mean, you had all the great bluesmen of his time, but Robert was a good showman. He was fun to see. He knew how to include everybody in the show. He would do Got Your Mojo Working or something like that, and you would believe you were in a great big show somewhere, and you were in the little bitty Bluebird in Fort Worth, Texas.
His repertoire of songs was fairly limited, but it was the blues standards he grew up with. There was not, like when this band started and over the course of its lifetime, there wasn't like a learning curve. They didn't rehearse. He didn't learn new songs. It is what it is.
Right.
And what you saw was what you got.
We never got paid. He still owes me. No, we didn't make much. We did it because we liked it.
Yeah, I love it. He was, look, he's counting out the money and having a stack of money. It didn't matter if it was a 5 or a 20 or a 1.
Yeah.
But he usually ended up with a 20.